before I get started, the boss spoke and said the 3 minutes don't apply to me. So don't yank me off, please. All right. But as he rose and rebuked the winds, he said unto the sea, peace, be still. We're living in challenging times, and often I retreat to some of my calming spaces where I find clarity, understanding, direction, purpose, and peace. While retreating last week, I had an opportunity to observe not just local, not just coastal, but global responses in magnitude in regards to the impact of this global goodwill ambassador to this world. Saw, searching for clarity, a young lady posts a picture, Sweet Lou, video of Gator sliding one of his dribbling routines. And you could see in the video Obi Dobson sitting over there swinging the ball, moving around a couple of times. And then Sweet Lou, what he normally do to all us dribblers, when he give it to us, he say, lay it down. Lay it down. And that's what Gator did, laid it down. But what brought clarity to that was this grandmother stressing because this little boy took lessons from Gator Rivers. And she was stressing because he was in his new pants, walking on his knees like Gator Rivers. My response was, don't worry about those pants. I'll buy them the next pair when the hole get in them. Because what he has received from Gator was the blueprint. The blueprint. That's clarity. And then I saw a Facebook post by his stepdaughter in Missouri. And she basically said, Gator gave me the blueprint from A to Z to make all, not some, all my dreams come true. She now leads one of the largest and most successful AAU programs in Missouri using the same blueprint. More profoundly, she said she now used the blueprint to raise her own family. And then I made one phone call that I thought Gator would want me to make. And it was to his daughter, Laura. Did not know what I was walking into, but I said, she answered the phone with such enthusiasm. I was blown back. And she said, I said, how are you? She said, Bruce, I'm good. My daddy helped people all over the world. And what daughter wouldn't love that? So because she was so happy, I pushed the envelope a little bit. And I asked her, what did you get from the blueprint? And she said, I remember first he said, follow through. It's like, wow. And then she say, number two, it's true for the shot. Am I right? It's true for the shot. And everything you do and reach challenges is true for the shot. And then she said, the last one she remembered, He said, start strong. But he said, watch the ball until it go all the way through the hoop. Because the next man have turned around not knowing whether he made it or missed it. And then I start thinking, wow, there's a lot of irony to that. Because Laura went on to be an extraordinary volleyball player at Howard University, following through. Today, using those same blueprint, she is a successful labor lawyer in Atlanta, Georgia. The same blueprint. And then I saw response from Hollywood Brown, Tyrone. Tyrone just kept it simple. Tyrone said, the man is my hero. He basically understood that many of his opportunities would not have happened if Gator would not have come home and take him by the hand and gave him the blueprint. Tyrone turned around, gave the blueprint to Sugar Bear. And then after that, here come Kevin Sutton, Showbiz Jackson, Ty Randolph, Chu Smith, all benefits of the blueprint. And then Sweet Lou, when he handed Gator that ball and said, lay it down, in that same video, Sweet Lou. And by the way, Sweet Lou will go down as one of the most greatest showmen in Harlem Globetrotter history. Also saw Sweet Lou on Love Boat the other day with Gator River. They had about 20 of them in one cabin. Sweet Lou also have the distinction in that the Globetrotters is coming up on their 100th anniversary. And Sweet Lou has the distinction of being there all 100 years. And then, I see Bobby over there. Bobby and Gator freaking frat. Bobby and Gator created an assertive campaign about 10, 15 years ago to increase the Globetrotter membership for the National Basketball Retired Players Association. It's an organization of former NBA players, Globetrotters, WNBA players, and ABA players. The mission is to make life easier for us athletes as we transition into the real world. They created that campaign, and many of us jumped on board following Bobby and Gator. And while there, Dave Naves comes into the picture. And if you know Dave Naves' relationship with Gator, it's extraordinary. Dave Naves can retire today, but he's a profound, extremely important worker for NASA, and he still remains. Dave and I have in the can before the pandemic hit to do STEM basketball camps, science, technology, engineering, and math, partly because Gator could take the ball and do a speech showing you how science, technology, engineering, and math applies to basketball. Dave goes on and sat on the board for the National Basketball Retired Players Association, supported by Gator and Bobby and so many others. Immediately when he got on the board, the first thing he did was appointed Chu Smith to work on committees. Dave serves out his time. It's over. Now Chew became on the board. Well, just recently, Chew is a former Harlem Globetrotter who is launching something called Communiversity, where he's establishing universities in communities where everybody from the youngest to great grandma can go learn something, take advantage of resources, and he's launching that. Chew went on to serve now not just on the board, but he's chairman of the board. And immediately upon being announced, the first thing he did was he reached out to Sugar Bear and put me on the committees. So now I'm on a committee. So guess what? The blueprint is alive and well, and we will carry it on. And then I got that call, fellas, I'm gonna look at my Globetrotters brothers right here. I got that call from our living GOAT, our hero. When he speak, we all listen. And his name is Hubert Geese Austin. You know him as Geese. And Geese conversation with me, I can't even begin to go in because it was emotional on both sides. But more importantly, outside of the emotion, he brought me peace with his words, because he too and Gator have a long, long, long history. So with that being said, y'all, it brings me to the point of, what did Gator really want? What did he really, really want? And I can tell you, because he kept me up 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning every night telling me. But one of the things he wanted to do was bring that blueprint to Savannah and help so many young people with his blueprint. He wanted it right here, because every place he'd been before, he laid down that blueprint and was successful. He came home and he simply wanted a selfie with the 67 trophy. He couldn't find it. He couldn't find it. He finally found it, and his heart, I can tell you, was broken, because the trophy was in 5 pieces. He understood history. He understood how history shaped our future. He felt that it was important that kids understand the importance of that 67 game. He just didn't want to shine because he was on the team. He wanted it to shine because of its significance. He took the trophy, and I think he tried to repair it. He gave it to the powers to be. I don't know exactly who, but all of a sudden, trophy's not here no more. It's not here no more. So this campaign, I don't like to come talk without action plans. So I think all y'all should take out your phone. All y'all in the world listening, hashtag, where's the trophy? All he wanted to do was to have the trophy enshrined so people can understand his significance. See, he understood history like George Santayana, the famous Spanish-American philosopher. He said, if you don't remember your past, you're condemned to repeat it. You're condemned to repeat it, and that's both ways. He understood that, because see, what he knew was his whole thing started with a dream. And what made the dream came through was the guys before him on Crawford Square, the guys before him on Cam Park, and the guys before him at Beats. What we both also understood, that even in my era, I had visual examples from visionaries. So when I came in on the scene, I immediately was buried in my mind the impact of Joe Green. I was buried in my mind the impact of Russell Ellington. I was buried in my mind the impact of David Hall. It was buried in my mind guys like Andrew Knowles. It was buried in my mind, like Roger Moore. It was buried in my mind deep by the guy by the name of Larry Gator River. And all he wanted for these young people today to see that same vision. He felt it was missing. He said the name on the front of the building wasn't enough. He said when kids walk through Beach High Halls, he said, because bare walls don't talk. He said he wanted them to walk through and the first thing they see is images and memorabilia of Joe Green. He wanted images and memorabilia of Russell Ellington, of David Hall, of Andrew Knowles, and of course, Larry Gator River. He wanted that. He didn't just want that for Beach. He wanted it for Johnson, and he wanted it for all the high schools because he understood its significance and the impact and the importance of the history. So I challenge you again. When those kids walk through those schools in this city, don't let those walls be hollow. Okay? From that blueprint, I coached basketball for 20 years, college level. And in those 20 years, I took that same blueprint and have produced over 150-some athletes that have gone on to play Division I, Division II, NAIA, overseas, and got about four of them right now scratching at the NBA, all from Gator River's blueprint. So if it's working all over the world, it sure need to work here in Savannah, Georgia. See, what we have is what I call the less than 0.5 percenters. Those are the people who put a roadblock in front of everything he tried to do. But he's not at the pearly gates because of that 0.5%. He's at the pearly gates because of the 99.5% of the responses to his real work in this society that we live in. See, what people, I hear a lot all the time, what people didn't realize that Gator was smart, extremely smart, intelligent, visionary. I used to always try to one-up him because I knew how great he was. And I remember back in like 2002, I went and obtained my master's degree and focusing on biomechanics and exercise physiology. And one of the first things I did was I said, I got to go to Gator because I got him. I got him. So I went and I started explaining and talking the knowledge about biomechanics. And he just said that how he do, Yeah, that's pretty good. So the joke was on me because the next time he took me to a speaking engagement, he said, these kids need to hear your story. So I went and I went first and I told my story. And when I went to sat down, it was time for the big dog to come up. And when he came up, he did my whole 15 classes of master program in a speech with a basketball. He taught my whole master's degree in 30 minutes. Impact, smart, and intelligent. So while I got my guy holed up right there at the pearly gates, I can just imagine his entry. Because y'all, what y'all don't know, that Larry Gator Rivers just joined God's heavenly Harlem Globetrotter dream team. The dream team. Because see, what y'all don't know that I know all them boys over there know, that Billy Ray, Gator mentored Billy Ray. And Billy Ray had this thing where he could catch the ball and hold it behind his back and sit there and wave at you like this. So I can imagine at the pearly gates, Billy Ray gonna be the first person he sees. And he's gonna be standing there and he's gonna say, yo, Judge, come on in. He gonna give him that ball, and I can see Gator sliding through the pearly gates. And when he slide, he liked to look at the girls in the stand. He slide through the pearly gates, and as he looked up there, he sees Laura, his mother, who started the dream by taking him to the old Star Theater to watch Go Man Go. And that's when he was introduced to Marcus Haynes and knew exactly what he wanted to do for the rest of his life. The journey continued walking from the Star Theater, and he saw an image in the showcase of a basketball and told his mom he had to have it. And his mom would actually play with him. And he would dribble the ball, and he loved it. And what he did was he took that in his own mind and created magic. See, the ball is just an illusion that y'all talk about. It's the message behind the ball that's most important. So after Billy Roy, he slide on in there. He going to hop up, and there's Curly Neal sitting over there. He going to slide over to Curly Neal, and they going to give their dap like they always do. And he going to hop up, and he going to look up, and he going to hear that loud pitch voice of Metal Lock Lemon. Say, Gator, bring that thing over here. And he going to slide over to Metal Lock, and when he hopped up, he's going to be amazed. Because what is he going to see? He's going to see Marcus Haynes, the man that started the dribbler. And there's hard to find, it's getting good now, but it's hard to find guys who can handle the ball better than Marcus Haynes and Larry Gator Rivers. Myself, Tyrone Hollywood Brown, Ty Randolph, we all tried to be better than all of them. I'll let them speak for myself. I never did it that good, because Marcus Haynes and Larry Gator Rivers set the tone. So as he laid down with Marcus, and he slides to Marcus, and Marcus said, Gator, what I taught you, job well done. Job well done. Because ultimately what you have done, if you've left the blueprint for the world, I just want Savannah, Georgia, and Beach High School to take that blueprint and not let it go in vain. Because when you look over there, we have good stewards of the blueprint. Good stewards of the blueprint. So before I walk off the stage, before I'm getting pulled off, oh, one more thing, please. Don't pull me off. I got to show y'all this. This is my tailor-made Larry Gator Rivers tie. Check it out, y'all. Check it out. So, Luke, I'm coming to you, baby. I'm coming to you. So, one more time, I need you to say, Gator, lay it down. Lay it down.
We will now listen to the alma mater. The Beach alma mater.
Yeah.
Audrey Andrews.
Good evening. I'm going to just read a few of the ones that the family asked me to read. With sympathy in the loss of your husband, no time on earth is long enough to share with those we love. Nothing can prepare our hearts to say goodbye. May the sympathy of those who care about you and the precious memory of your husband help to comfort you at this time. My condolences, Jacqueline Seymour and family. Remembering their beautiful song, God gives every person their own unique song. It is one that will play their entire life long. Though the love they gave and the gifts that they share, through the memories they make and the dreams they dare. It is a song filled with beauty and day-to-day grace that plays until they see God face to face. A song that is heard in the heart, loud and clear. A song, if we listen, we'll always hear. What a beautiful way to celebrate them. Through the song they live, the song will carry you forever in your heart. Mayor Jerry Lee Miller from Mayville, South Carolina. We have several resolutions, which I will not read. I will just acknowledge them. We have Beach High, the congressional record from Honorable Earl Buddy Carter. We have one from the World Conference of Mayors, a joint resolution from the World Conference of Mayors and the Historic Black Towns and Settlements Alliance Incorporated in memory of the Honorable Harlem Globetrotters legend, Larry Gator Rivers. We also have one from the United States Senate from Reverend Raphael Warnock. And we have one from Second Ebenezer Missionary Baptist Church, a resolution of respect for Brother Larry Gator Rivers. Expression of thanks. With sincere appreciation, we, the family of Commissioner Larry Gator Rivers, wishes to thank you for your kindness during our time of sorrow. Perhaps you sent a lovely card or sat quietly in a chair. Perhaps you sent those flowers that we saw sitting there. Perhaps you spoke the kindest words, as many friends could say. Perhaps you were not there at all, just thought of us today. Whatever you did to console our hearts, we thank you so much for whatever part. Thank you for keeping us in your thoughts and prayers. May God continue to bless you. A very special thank you to the Reverend Dr. Thurman and the St. Paul CME Church and the Southern Palette. The repast will be held immediately following the service at the Ralph Mark Gilbert Civil Rights Museum at 460 Martin Luther King Boulevard. Thank you.
Thank you so much. At this time, I would like to thank the family, especially my sister Jean, for allowing me the privilege of serving as your presider for this occasion. The only thing I can always remember is my oldest grandson spinning a ball on his finger because he wanted to be Gator Rivers. We will now have a selection from the Voices of Praise. Following that, we'll have the words of comfort from our very own, the Reverend Dr. DeAndre Thurman Sr.
Church, say amen. Let the church say amen. God has spoken. Let the church say amen. Let the church
Somebody say amen. If you believe in the word, let the whole church say amen. God has spoken, so let the church say amen.
Let the church say amen. Mm-hmm. Let the church,
everybody,
say.
Let the church,
let the church
say,
say amen.
Can I get a witness?
Let the church,
oh,
say amen.
For what his words say,
let the church,
for what his plans
say,
are,
amen.
God has spoken,
God has spoken.
Let the church,
let the church say. Let the church
say amen.
Let the church say amen. God has spoken.
Let the church,
let the church
say,
say amen.
Let this be your response. Whatever he said,
amen.
From the healing of your body,
amen.
To the raising of the dead,
amen.
No matter how you're feeling,
amen.
Or how your world is really,
amen.
The battle is not yours,
amen.
It belongs to the Lord,
amen.
Even as your,
amen.
I heard him.
Let the church say amen.
Let the church say
amen.
From the healing of your body.
Amen. Amen.
Rest in peace.
Amen.
Rest of your body.
Amen. Amen.
Let the church,
let the church,
let the church
say amen.
Gracious God, we thank you for who you are and for what you are. We thank you for the opportunity to gather on this day, to be in this place, O God, and to one more time experience your goodness, your grace, and your mercy. Lord, we thank you for the life of Brother Larry Gator Rivers. We thank you, O God, for all that you are and all that you mean to us so that we can celebrate even in a time like this. So now bless your son and your servant. Anoint me afresh and anew. In the name of Jesus, preach, Holy Ghost, preach. And all who love God would say amen. Do you mind giving God just one more hand clap of praise in this place? We are gathered here today to celebrate the life, the love, the legacy, and the bright light of Brother Larry Gator Rivers, and to thank our glorious and grand God for the high privilege of allowing our paths to cross with his in some way. Today, friends, not only do we seek to celebrate a journey completed, a life well lived, a saint who has gone to be with his Savior, but also we come today to offer words of comfort to this beloved family and to this community. My prayer is that those that knew Brother Rivers as a husband, father, grandfather, family member, mentor, public servant, and most of all, a friend, will find a sweet peace and unity because we have spent this time together. So thank you, Sister Rivers and family, for I am extremely humbled to stand in this place for this task, and it's a high honor that you ask me. As I prayed about what the Lord would have me to say today, I reflected like so many others that are here today. And I do want to do this. I do want to ask all of the ministers of the gospel that are in this place, would you stand so that this family can know you're praying for them in this moment? All ministers of the gospel. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. As I prayed on this day about what the Lord would have me to say, I reflected like others on the many interactions I had with Brother Rivers. Often, for he and I, it was about discussing our youth or discussing young adults and the issues that were around young adults, or discussing our city and how we could help to make our community better than it always already is. I finally remember many Sundays before the pandemic when Brother and Sister Rivers would attend not just 8 o'clock service or not just 11 o'clock service, but they would often attend a lightly attended 3 p.m. healing worship service that Dr. Jordan led. And often after that 3 o'clock worship service, in the next 10 minutes, Brother Gator and I would seemingly solve all the problems of the world. He and I had that relationship where we would talk, and we would talk every time we saw each other. He was so kind to me. He'd always greet me and always have a word for me. And I thought about how much Brother Gator meant to so many, and I heard so many meaningful memories from others. But I have my own story of his loving spirit and his grand vision for the betterment of our society. Several years ago, before the pandemic, I was asked by a wonderful principal, middle school principal in our school system here in Savannah, to help in providing mentorship to one of our local middle schools, John Hubert Middle School. And so after serving on the school council for a few months and looking at many different options, we were presented with the option came that we could develop what was called at that time a Christian basketball league in conjunction with several other churches in the community. I got permission from the principal and the staff to invite all of the boys of that school who wanted to play basketball, most of whom had not made the team, that we would offer them the opportunity to play basketball. And on that first meeting, when I showed up at the school, nearly 100 middle school boys showed up in the gymnasium. That sounds good, doesn't it? What was I gonna do now? I certainly didn't have enough coaches for nearly 100 kids. It's almost impossible to keep the attention of 100 middle school boys in a gymnasium with bouncing basketballs. And on top of that, every one of these 100 little boys thought they were either LeBron James or Steph Curry. What was I going to do? Then it hit me. I know what I'll do. I'll call the one Harlem Globetrotter I know. I'll call that Wizard of the Hardwood. I'll call that championship-winning Gator Rivers. And just like I expected, when I called, he answered and he agreed to meet me at the very next gathering of those young men. I just knew when Brother Rivers showed up that day, he'd come in the gym with his red, white, and blue jacket on. I just knew that when Gator showed up that day, he would dazzle the kids with balls spinning on his finger or throwing balls with passes behind his back or making unbelievable half-court shots. But instead of all of that, that day when he showed up, he spent more than an hour teaching the boys what a proper stance was. How to hold and control the ball. How to make a good pass. I hope you hear me. On that day, rather than fancy footwork or highlight reel showmanship, or amazing dribbling wizardry, Brother Rivers spent time, his entire time, teaching the kids basketball was not so much about putting the ball in the basket as it was about respecting the game, building character, and developing relationships with your teammates. He spent time pouring into those children what was really important. There's a passage in the 25th chapter of the Gospel of Matthew where Jesus tells a story of a man going on a journey, and before he leaves, he entrusts his wealth with his servants. To one servant, he gives one bag. To another servant, he gives two bags. To another servant, he gives five bags. And the man who received five gained five more. The man who received two gained two more. But the man who received one buried his gift, fearing what might go wrong rather than what might go right. I would have you know, on May 6, 1949, God gave a little brown baby born in Savannah, Georgia, several gifts. And that little brown baby named Larry grew up to be a man nicknamed Gator that took those gifts and valued those gifts and sharpened those gifts and then shared those gifts. Valued them, sharpened them, and shared them so much that his gifts made room for him. And he traveled to faraway lands. He entertained millions and made friends all around the world. But what was most amazing was, though he was privileged to travel to Australia and Africa and Europe and Asia, and he, what was wonderful is that though he was able to see all of these great lands, what was most amazing is that he brought those wonderful gifts back to his home in Savannah, Georgia, and made a difference in the lives of little girls and little boys. Not just those born in mansions, but also those born in mobile homes. He dazzled not just presidents and politicians, but he played pickup games with those suffering in poverty. He was concerned not just with those in elected positions and high offices, but he was concerned and cared for those who were unemployed and uneducated and unfulfilled. And because he took the gifts he had been given and made the most of his talents, I believe that 73 years after he first received them, he heard those wonderful words, "Well done, thy good and thy faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things, and now I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of the Lord." So yeah, Sugar Bear, somehow I believe the spirit of Brother Larry Gator Rivers is standing somewhere around God's great altar. And he's standing there with no more sickness. He's standing there with no more pain. He's standing there with no more problems of this society. But he's standing there singing, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Thank you, Lord, for how you lifted me. Thank you, Lord, for how you blessed me. And thank you, Lord, for allowing me to share what you shared with me. Somewhere singing, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. And while he's singing it, he's got a ball spinning on his finger. Amen. 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 With all of the ministers that are near me, would you please stand now? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Amen. Might we just pause for one moment? Might we pause for just one moment? The word says, for this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when the corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and the mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. For as much as the Spirit has left this body and returned to God who gave it, we do commit this body now, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth and sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body. Let the people of God say, amen, amen. And now we will receive this parting blessing. Amen, amen. And now may the love of God, and now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and now may the sweet communion and presence of the Holy Spirit rest with you and rule with you and abide with you now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let every believer of God say amen. Would everyone but the family please stand? Amen. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me.
All types of diseases, people are slipping away. The economy's down, people don't get enough pay. But as for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you done for me. Yeah. We got folks without homes living out in the streets, and the drug addicts, some say they just can't beat. Muggers and robbers, no place seem to be safe. But you've been my protection every step of the way. And I gotta say, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah, it could have been me. Keep on keeping me, and I gotta say,